everyone, my name is Iris France, and today we're going to talk about nominal interest rate and real interest rate. So I'll give you the bottom line first. Nominal interest rate minus inflation rate is approximately equal to real interest rate. So what's the difference between nominal interest rate and real interest rate? Nominal interest rate is the definitions here, the rate at which your deposit grows. And real interest rate is the interest rate adjusted for inflation. So the definition is the rate at which the purchasing power of your deposit grows. And really, when we deposit money in a bank, what we really care about is at the end of the day, when we get back our principal and our interest, how much more goods and services can we purchase? So what you really care about is the real interest rate. So we're going to illustrate with a very simple example. Suppose you have $100. And the price of a pack of chalks is $1 this year. So if you don't make a deposit and you go ahead and purchase some chalks, how many packs can you purchase? So that will be 100 divided by 1, and you will be able to buy 100 packs of chalks if you don't make the deposit. But if you deposit your $100 in the bank, now suppose the nominal interest rate is equal to 10%. Then you deposit the money, by the end of the year, you can get your principal plus interest, that will be $110. And now, how many packs of chalk can you buy? Because remember, that's what we care about. We want to know how much more goods and services we can get from our deposit. And during this year, the inflation rate, say, is 3%. Now, inflation rate is the rate at which price level grows. So that means last year, your price of chalks is $1, and because inflation rate is 3%, so now this year the price of chalk is not $1 anymore, it's approximately $1.03. So when you're calculating how many packs of chalks you can buy, you will have to divide 110, that's the principal and interest after 1 year you get from the bank. Divide 110 by the price of chalks this year, so that will be $1.03. And after you calculate that, you get 106.7, which is approximately equal to 107. So your real interest rate tells you approximately the purchasing power of your deposit has grown by 7%. So now you wonder, why is that approximately equal to, why is not equal to 7%? Here's the reason. What I'm doing is that, look, I'm going to call nominal interest rate as the large R, and inflation rate as I, and real interest rate as a small r. What I've been doing here is that you can see 1 plus nominal interest rate is actually equal to 1 plus inflation rate times 1 plus real interest rate. And after you expand it, you will see that nominal interest rate is actually equal to inflation rate plus real interest rate plus inflation rate times real interest rate. And because this term is so tiny, so we just kind of cross it out because it's so small, we can just kind of ignore that. And we say nominal interest rate is approximately equal to inflation rate plus real interest rate. And therefore you get this equation here. So thanks for watching and good luck with your studying.